The present is all we have to live in or to lose. Stop whatever you're doing for a moment and ask yourself, am I afraid of death because I won't be able to do this anymore? Let each thing you would do, say, or intend be like that of a dying person.
Hello and welcome to this video summary of Meditations by Marcus Aurelius. This book is a collection of personal writings by the Roman emperor, who was also a Stoic philosopher. Meditations is a timeless classic that offers practical wisdom and guidance on how to live a virtuous life. In this video, we will be discussing the key themes and ideas from the book and exploring how they can be applied in our own lives. So, whether you're new to Stoicism or a seasoned practitioner, I hope this video will inspire you to reflect on your own life and help you to cultivate greater wisdom, courage, and resilience.
There really isn't anything radically wrong with being sick or with dying. Who said you're supposed to survive? Who gave you the idea that it's a gas to go on and on and on? And we can't say that it's a good thing for everything to go on living, from the very simple demonstration that if we enable everybody to go on living, we overcrowd ourselves. So therefore, one person who dies in a way is honorable, because he's making room for others.
Without further ado, let's dive into the first part of our summary, the concept of death and transience in life. In Meditations, Marcus Aurelius reflects on the transience of life and the inevitability of death. He reminds us that life is fleeting and that we should not take our time on this earth for granted. Instead, we should make the most of every moment and live our lives with purpose and meaning. One of the most famous passages in the book is from chapter 6, where Marcus Aurelius writes, "You could leave life right now. Let that determine what you do and say and think." This passage serves as a powerful reminder that life is unpredictable and that we should make the most of every moment we have. Another key idea that Marcus Aurelius explores in Meditations is the importance of accepting the transience of life. He writes that we should not cling to things that are outside of our control, such as our material possessions or our reputation. Instead, we should focus on cultivating inner virtues such as wisdom, courage, and justice, which are the things that truly matter. So, how can we apply these ideas in our own lives? One way is to practice gratitude for the present moment and the people and things that bring us joy. We can also cultivate a sense of detachment from our material possessions and focus on the things that truly matter, such as our relationships and personal growth. By embracing the transience of life and living with purpose and meaning, we can find greater fulfillment and happiness in our lives. In the next part of our summary, we will be exploring the concept of courage and resilience and how we can cultivate these virtues in our own lives.
One of the most powerful exercises in Stoicism is the exercise of amor fati, the idea that there is no such thing as an obstacle, there's only fuel. So Marcus Aurelius talks about fire being the metaphor for the life of a Stoic. Everything you throw in front of a fire, he says, is fuel for the fire. It turns obstacles into brightness and flame, he says. So you want to go through your life not thinking about all the problems and all the difficulties. You want to think about all that these obstacles and difficulties are offering you, the fuel that it's providing for you. So a Stoic loves everything. That's what amor fati translates to, a love of fate. And it means that there is nothing that can slow you down because everything is actually taking you exactly in the direction that you want to go.
The concept of courage and resilience. In Meditations, Marcus Aurelius also reflects on the importance of courage and resilience. He writes that life is full of challenges and obstacles, and it's important to approach these difficulties with courage and determination. One way to cultivate courage and resilience is to embrace the idea of amor fati, which means love of fate in Latin. This concept involves accepting whatever happens in life and seeing it as an opportunity for growth and learning. By embracing this mindset, we can develop a greater sense of inner strength and resilience, which can help us overcome even the toughest challenges. Another way to cultivate courage and resilience is to practice negative visualization. This involves imagining the worst-case scenario in a given situation and preparing ourselves mentally and emotionally for it. By doing so, we can develop a greater sense of inner strength and resilience, which can help us overcome even the toughest challenges. For example, let's say you're about to give a big presentation at work. Instead of just hoping for the best, you can imagine all the things that could go wrong, your computer crashing, the audience being unresponsive, etc. By mentally preparing for these scenarios, you can approach the presentation with greater confidence and resilience, knowing that you can handle whatever comes your way. Finally, it's worth noting that cultivating courage and resilience is not just about facing external challenges. It's also about cultivating inner virtues such as self-discipline, perseverance, and humility. By developing these qualities, we can become more resilient in the face of adversity and better able to handle whatever life throws our way. In the next part of our summary, we will be exploring the concept of empathy and how we can cultivate greater compassion and understanding in our relationships with others.
First, compassion is comprised of that capacity to see clearly into the nature of suffering. It is that ability to really stand strong and to recognize also that I'm not separate from this suffering. But that is not enough, because compassion, which activates the motor cortex, means that we actually aspire to transform suffering. And if we're so blessed, we engage in activities that transform suffering.
The concept of empathy and compassion in relationships. In Meditations, Marcus Aurelius also reflects on the importance of empathy and compassion in our relationships with others. He reminds us that we are all connected and that our actions and attitudes can have a profound impact on those around us. One way to cultivate greater empathy and compassion is to practice active listening. This involves giving our full attention to the person we're talking to without interrupting or judging them. By doing so, we can develop a greater understanding of their perspective and build stronger, more meaningful relationships. Another way to cultivate empathy and compassion is to put ourselves in other people's shoes. This involves imagining what it would be like to be in their position and experiencing the same challenges or emotions they're facing. By doing so, we can develop a greater sense of empathy and compassion, which can help us be more supportive and understanding in our relationships with others. For example, let's say a friend is going through a difficult time and is feeling overwhelmed and stressed. Instead of just giving them advice or trying to fix their problems, you can take a moment to imagine what it would be like to be in their shoes. By doing so, you can approach the situation with greater empathy and compassion and offer them the support and understanding they need. Finally, it's worth noting that cultivating empathy and compassion is not just about our relationships with others. It's also about cultivating inner virtues such as kindness, patience, and forgiveness. By developing these qualities, we can become more compassionate and understanding towards ourselves and others, and create more positive, fulfilling relationships in our lives. In the final part of our summary, we will be exploring the concept of the present moment and how we can cultivate greater mindfulness and awareness in our daily lives.
Well, good exercise for that. It's like a prayer in some sense. In fact, I would say it's proper prayer. If you want to know something about yourself, sit on your bed one night and say to yourself, you got to mean this, like you got to be desperate. This is no game, this. You ask yourself, you sit on the bed and say, okay, man, I'm ready to learn something. Like what's one thing I'm doing wrong that I know I'm doing wrong that I could fix, that I would fix? It's like you meditate on that, you'll get an answer. And it won't be one you want, but it'll be the necessary one.
The concept of the present moment and mindfulness. In Meditations, Marcus Aurelius reflects on the importance of being present in the moment and cultivating mindfulness in our daily lives. He reminds us that life is fleeting and that the only moment we truly have is the present one. One way to cultivate mindfulness is to practice attention training. This involves intentionally focusing our attention on the present moment, without judgment or distraction. By doing so, we can develop a greater sense of awareness and connection to the world around us. Another way to cultivate mindfulness is to practice gratitude. This involves intentionally focusing on the things we're grateful for, no matter how small or insignificant they may seem. By doing so, we can develop a greater sense of appreciation for the present moment and cultivate a more positive, fulfilling outlook on life.
There are studies showing that a regular gratitude practice can provide resilience to trauma in two ways. It can provide a reframing and resilience to prior traumatic experiences, so buffering people against the negative physiological effects and psychological effects of earlier trauma, but also inoculating them in many ways to any traumas that might arrive later in life. So that's a powerful thing.
Finally, it's worth noting that cultivating mindfulness is not just about our own personal well-being. It's also about developing a greater sense of connection and empathy towards the world around us. By being fully present in the moment, we can appreciate the beauty and complexity of the world and become more aware of our own impact on the people and environment around us.
Is pay more attention to the situation and to the people that you're talking to. So you have to increase the degree to which you're attending outwardly, and that'll stop you from attending inwardly. That's a very effective technique. You can practice that, generally speaking. Every time you get nervous, start paying more attention, and that'll help you out a lot.
Stoic philosophy can be a useful tool for navigating the challenges of life. By focusing on what we can control and accepting what we cannot, we can develop a sense of inner peace and resilience that allows us to weather difficult times with greater ease. Mindfulness and self-awareness are core components of Stoicism and are emphasized throughout meditations. By being present in the moment and reflecting on our own thoughts and actions, we can gain a deeper understanding of ourselves and cultivate greater clarity and focus in our lives. One of the key themes of meditations is the importance of empathy and compassion. By treating others with kindness and understanding, we can build stronger relationships and contribute to a more harmonious society. This message is particularly relevant in today's world, where empathy and understanding are sorely needed. Although meditations is a deeply personal work, it contains many universal themes and insights that are still relevant today. By reflecting on Marcus Aurelius' meditations, we can gain a deeper understanding of the human experience and our place in the world. Finally, meditations is not just a philosophical treatise, but a practical guide to living a more fulfilling life. The idea of accepting what we cannot control can be difficult to put into practice, but it is ultimately liberating. By letting go of our attachment to outcomes, we can focus our energy on the things that matter most and find greater peace and fulfillment in life. The concept of living in accordance with nature is central to Stoic philosophy and can be interpreted in many ways. For some, it may mean living in harmony with the natural world. For others, it may mean aligning one's actions with one's own true nature or values. Either way, this concept invites us to reflect on our place in the world and our relationship to the larger universe. Meditations emphasizes the importance of personal responsibility and self-improvement. By focusing on our own thoughts and actions, and striving to be the best version of ourselves, we can have a positive impact on the world around us. The practice of daily reflection and meditation can be a powerful tool for personal growth and self-awareness. By taking time to reflect on our thoughts and actions, we can identify areas for improvement and cultivate greater mindfulness and self-awareness. The message of empathy and compassion in meditations is not just relevant to our relationships with others, but also to our relationship with ourselves. By treating ourselves with kindness and compassion, we can build greater resilience and self-confidence and be better equipped to face life's challenges. Overall, the conclusions we draw from meditations will depend on our own experiences and interpretations of the text. but by engaging with its ideas and reflecting on its message, we can gain valuable insights into ourselves, our world, and our place in it.